All right, the second attempt at a summary of what has gone on the NOI training so far. We are Monday at 1 p.m. I think the next session is in like 5 minutes here after lunch. And the first attempt didn't really work out. I was trying to do it while walking, and not really a good idea. So let's see. The first day we went over models. It's very useful, and I was always shocked because I always thought models was this complicated thing that you do with a statistical software. And we did a basic one, but we did an Excel. So it was a little bit crazy. We did a quick survey of people in the area, and two variables, and just very quickly did an analysis based on the decision tree model. So it brought it down to earth, and it's great. I think a great thing is that there are a lot of smart people here. I think they're much smarter than me, and they have much more political experience. So I just listen, and I'm like, oh, that's very interesting. And a lot of this problem solving, we sit down and most basic statistical or data management stuff, people get it right away. We're not stuck. A little more complicated, like we do regressions, and if people show us a formula, maybe half will get it. It's a very good crowd. The model was great, but some people might get too carried out with that, so we had a whole session just talking about how you can actually use it, and how do you make it relevant for the campaign. Something else that's interesting is that a lot of the discussion is focused around voters, people here are not just voters, but partisan campaigns. So whenever we say supporters, we mean Democrats. But there's some other people working on the different issues. Oh, there's Horacio. Hey, Horacio, say hi. Oh, just to the recording. Oh, and it's really nice over here. Very nice, very nice.
I'm here because I'm looking for the gym, so.
Yes, Horacio is trying to work out.
Yeah.
We only have like 3 minutes left.
Yeah.
What was I gonna say? So you can get carried out. So how do you use it? How do you implement it? And we have a whole session, how do you convince your campaign director about, okay, let's use the model as opposed to their old tried method of like, oh, let's go talk to your grandma's friends because all your friends are going to be persuaded by grandma, that kind of thing. And like, how do we move from that anecdotal experience and basis to a data-based strategizing? And how do you convince people? So, I was saying that there's a lot of partisan campaign, but there are people who do union organizing, there are people like us who do non-partisan campaigns, and I think it'll all help us. And there's a guy from ISI, I need to ask him about his insight, who says has experience doing the scoring, because a lot of it the basic tenet of the campaign planning relies on the voter turnout propensity score, as well as the voter democratic candidate support index score. And the democratic candidate support index, we can't use it at KRC. So apparently there's other ways of modeling around that's nonpartisan, and it's relevant for issues. So we'll check out what that is about. After that, we had the main highlight, which was how do you plan your universe, how do you separate universes. So we separated into teams and gave this imaginary campaign scenario, and each team had to figure out. We had about 8 people in each team, and each team got into a different level of progress. So our team's highlight, I think, well, at least what I did, was this. It was breakdown of the voters by whether they support the candidate, they don't support, and whether they're likely to vote or not. And with the regular, 3-6-9 quadrant analysis of the voters and did a count, and we ran into the problem that because they gave us a very low door contact rate efficiency, I don't remember if it was contact rate efficiency or persuasion rate, but of 20% instead of 40%, and people thought it was very low. Actually, for us, it's not that low. For us, it's like 10%, but of contact rate efficiency. But because of that, we need to reach out to other quadrants, and we're getting stuck. In the meantime, the other people, I think they didn't get stuck in this making pretty charts and did something more substantial. They might have also a better teamwork going on. I try to help people in the process of planning for precinct walking planning by making a chart, a distribution chart of how many precincts do we have with a certain number of doors in the multiple doors. But actually, after making it, it wasn't quite useless. It wasn't quite useful. That's that. And that's how we ended last night at 10 p.m. and then turned into a conference call. And then today morning, it was also very interesting. We did something much more even more realistic. So apparently all of the other data managers also get into the, or sometimes tangentially they do volunteer management, budget, and so forth. So how to do that based on data? And by the way, all this data, all this information, the textbooks, they made a very thick textbook for us, and it's under license under Creative Commons by Attribution Share Alike type license. The only difference is that instead of all, it just says NOI, but I think for every purpose it's the same thing. So. Where's the metrics? So it's the usual science of numbers, you know, how likely are they to turn out, how likely are they to support you, and based on that, how many people are left that you could attempt to reach. And it's interesting because it was a very large universe. The video was off because someone called me. I don't know who that person is, it's an 85. Anyway, it was like 500,000 voter universe, and you think, oh, that's for a big, very big campaign. But if you break it down, even if you don't campaign, or even if you do minimal campaign, like just media, that kind of thing, there's going to be a certain level of support for your candidate. So based on that, how do you increase it to a level where you make the necessary number of votes to win the race? And when you break it down, using a chart of, you know, who are likely to vote, who are likely to support, what percentage, you get down to a much smaller number of people who you actually need to mobilize. Now, to mobilize them, say if you want to mobilize 20,000 people, you can't just call 20,000 people and be done with it. It's a larger number, but it's much more manageable than dealing with 500,000 voters. So that was interesting. We talked about soft reports and hard reports. So the hard reports is the actual data. The soft reports is a quick summary that each field volunteer does to the supervisors, so that we have a quick glimpse of the campaign at any point in the moment. So we have debriefing the day of the precinct walking, so that even if we lose data, we have, well, hopefully we don't lose data, but even if the data is not immediately available, we have that. So actually, I think KRC's soft reports is probably too complicated. There are too many data fields. I just want to get the hard and fast facts, such as who said yes, who said no. And in this case, they're starting to classify everything into a 5-digit rank, 1 through 5, and 1 being the best, and 5 being the worst, and 3 undecided. So 1 to 5, and then how many didn't get through, and that's it. And just a memo section like, oh, this was great, this was bad. At KRC, we are having all these like not homes, disconnected, refused, and everything. And yeah, that's, I'm not going to look at that, and it's not going to be relevant for me. I can do that later with the hard data, but we need right on the spot is, you know, how much progress we're making in the campaign. So we should make some modifications on that. That's what we have so far, and in the afternoon we're going to go with some session. Actually, we're going to do campaign timeline planning using what we learned in the morning, I think. So yeah, it's great.